Good morning, America. Today is Friday, January the 12th, and it is 11:25 a.m. We are going to do a Proverbs today, Proverbs 19. It has 29 verses, and we have an array of colors here. We have pink for witnessing, black for sin, red for discipleship, yellow for family, blue for salvation. We have a couple of split verses. We have gold for prophecy. We have green for love. And those are all the colors that you will find in Proverbs 19. It is a Proverbs, miscellaneous Proverbs, which means that it talks about a number of things in this particular Proverbs. Okay, let's begin with a sound saying. We haven't had this all week, so since we're doing a Proverbs, we might as well do a sound saying. And this one says, it's coming from Psalms 37:40. And it says, "And God shall help them and deliver them. He shall deliver them from the wicked and save them because they trust in him." It pays to trust in God. Okay? For he is your deliverer. The back of it is from Psalms 103:8, and it says, "The Lord is merciful and gracious, slow to anger and plenteous in mercy." Okay, he is merciful and gracious, slow to anger and plenteous in mercy. All right, put that in the back. And let's begin with Psalms 19, miscellaneous Proverbs. The first one is pink. "Better is the poor that walketh in his integrity than he that is perverse in his lips and is a fool." A fool is always going to be perverse in their lips. Whatever comes to mind, they let it come out of their lips. It doesn't matter whether it's good, bad, ugly, disrespectful. None of that matters to a fool. Whatever comes to their heart comes out of their lips, okay? So that makes you have a perverse mouth. 2 and 3 are black for sin. "Also, that the soul be without knowledge, it is not good, and he that hastens with his feet sinneth," okay? A soul that has no knowledge is no good at all. In the same way that an egg that has not been cracked and it has nothing in it, when you shake it, it is no good. All right? So that's the same thing as a person with no knowledge. No good. All right? And he that has swift feet running into trouble usually sinneth. All right? 3, "The foolishness of man perverts his way, and his heart pritches against the Lord." Yes, absolutely. Whenever your heart is foolish, your mind is foolish, your heart and mind are twined together, and whenever your heart is foolish, you're less likely to please God. All right, so that's why it says his heart fritteth against the Lord. 4 is pink for witnessing. "Wealth maketh many friends, but the poor is separated from his neighbors." Of course, when you become rich, you have many friends, but many of those who count themselves as your friends are usually not your friends at all. All right? "Wealth maketh many friends, but the poor is separated from his neighbor." 5 is black again. "A false witness shall not be unpunished, and he that speaketh lies shall not escape." So if a witness says something that is incorrect or wrong, he will not go unpunished, because God is an all-knowing God. He sees, he hears, and he will reprimand you for your false witnessing. 6 and 7 is painful witnessing. Many will entrust the favor of the prince, and every man is a friend to him that giveth gifts. Yes, sir. A giver has many friends. A giver has many friends. 7. All the brethren of the poor do hate him, but how much more his friends go far from him. He pursues them with words, yet they are wanting to him. All the brethren of the poor do hate him. How much more do his friends go far from him? He pursues them with words, yet they are wanting to him. So the poor tend to have a hard time keeping good friends. But it's better to be poor and have a few good, genuine friends than it is to be rich and have many untrustworthy friends. Okay? 8 is read for discipleship. He that getteth wisdom loveth his own soul. He that keepeth understanding shall find good. And of course, with wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, only good will follow you anyhow. All right. 9. A false witness is black. A false witness shall not be unpunished. And he that speaketh lies shall perish. And perish doesn't always mean that you pass away. Perish can also mean that you lose things. All right. 10 is black. I'm sorry. Pink for witnessing. Delight is not seemly for a fool, much less for a servant to have rule over princes. Delight is not seemly for a fool, much less for a servant to have rule over his princes. 11 is read for discipleship. The discretion of a man deferreth his anger, and it is his glory to pass over a transgression. Amen. The discretion of a man deferreth his anger, and it is his glory to pass over a transgression. It is always a glory to pass over sin, because that's what transgression means, to sin. Okay, 12 is painful witnessing. The king's wrath is as the roaring of a lion, but his favor is as dew upon the grass. Amen. 13, a fool is yellow. A foolish son is the calamity of his father, and the contention of a wife are a continual dropping. 14 is also yellow for family. House and riches are the inheritance of fathers, and a prudent wife is from the Lord. Yes, sir. A prudent wife is a double blessing from the Lord. 15 is painful witnessing. Slothfulness casts into a deep sleep, and the idle soul shall suffer hungry. Slothful means that you are lazy. Okay? Slothfulness casts into a deep sleep, and an idle soul shall suffer hunger. 16 is our first split verse, part blue first, and it says, he that keepeth the commandment keepeth his own soul. All right, the black part says, but he that despises his way shall die. And they often do die young, those that are foolish, because they lack knowledge, understanding, and wisdom. So, therefore, when you lack these things, death becomes you when you lack these things. You get into trouble a lot. You make bad decisions. So it really is worth to get some wisdom, knowledge, and understanding under your belt. 17, he that has pity upon the poor lendeth unto the Lord. Amen. He that has pity upon the poor lendeth unto the Lord, and that which he has given will he pay him again. 18 is yellow for family. Chastise thy son while there is hope, and let not thy soul spare for his crying. So spare not the rod with your children, because although they have different techniques that you can use to discipline your children, the old school way is always the best. Not every new custom or every new way of doing things is better. Sometimes it's always better to embrace the old, because the old is more valuable than that which is new. All right. 19 is painful witnessing. A man of great wrath shall suffer punishment, for if thou deliverest him, yet thou must do it again. Yes, a man who is quick to be angry will eventually do something that will cause him to be punished for it. So it's very good to have a meek spirit, a humble spirit, because you're less likely to be foolish in your doing and in your speech. All right. 20 is another split verse. Pink comes first. Hear counsel and receive instructions. If you hear counsel and receive instructions, you are a wise individual, whether you're a man or a woman. The gold part says that thou mayest be wise in thy later years. Okay, so it's good to take counseling from your elders. 21 is that purple verse. There are many devices in a man's heart, nevertheless the counsel of the Lord that shall stand. Amen. There are many things in your heart, but any counseling from the Lord will always stand and do you good. 22 is all green. I'm sorry, it's a split verse, also part green and part pink for witnessing. The green part says the desire of a man is his kindness. The pink part says, and a poor man is better than a liar. Okay, the liars are among the seven things that the Lord hates, and a false witness and a liar is among those seven things. 23 is blue for your salvation. The fear of the Lord tendeth to life, and he that has it shall abide satisfied. He should not be visited with evil. Amen. The fear of the Lord tendeth to life, and he that has it shall abide satisfied. He should not be visited with evil. 24 and 25 are painful witnessing. A slothful man hideth his hand in his bosom, and will not so much as bring it to his mouth again. That's how lazy some individuals can be. 25, smite a scorner, and the simple will beware. And reproach one that has understanding, and he will understand knowledge. Amen. 26 is yellow for family. He that wastes his father and chases away his mother is a son that causes shame and bringeth reproach. Amen. He that wastes his father and casts away his mother is a son that causes shame and bringeth reproach. 27, it's painful witnessing. Cease, my son, to hear the instructions that causes to irk from the words of knowledge. Cease, my son, to hear the instructions that causes to irk from the words of knowledge. 28 and 29, the last two verses are black. And it says, an ungodly witness scorns judges, and the mouth of the wicked devours iniquity. An ungodly witness scorns judges at judgment. An ungodly witness scorns judgment, and the mouth of the wicked devours iniquity. 29, judgments are prepared for scorners, and stripes for the backs of fools. We don't do flagging anymore. Flagging was something that even our Lord experienced. He was flagged multiple times, more than 40 times, and then he was flagged again with a whip that had metal pieces on it, that every time it stroked our Lord, it would take chunks of his meat off of him, and this is what caused him to bleed all over right before the crucifixion. All right. So judgments are prepared for scorners, and stripes for the backs of fools. And this is something that we should still be doing today in 2018, publicly whipping people for what they do. Thank you very much for listening to us here at Spiritual Water. I hope you enjoyed the reading today. Today is Friday. Tomorrow is the Sabbath. I pray that you find time to rest above all things. And whatever is not done, it can be done on the first day of the week, which is Sunday. In the meantime, may the peace of God be upon thee. May the protection of God surround you. And may the will of God for your life come from thee. Until the next time, have a wonderful weekend.